Right, once again, want to give all praise to Yahweh Basham Yahushai. Right, double honors to the elder apostles of GMS that rule well. Right, salutations to the hopeful elect. Right, that doing this work out here in sincerity and in truth. Right, we are the Hebrew Israelites who basically come out here in the spirit of the Most High Yahweh Basham Yahushai. We are starting to wake up all people, right, back to their heritage, right, and to their knowledge of who they are. Somebody give me Isaiah 49 and this verse 6. Baba Kosha, read quick.
You understand? This is Isaiah chapter 49, verse 6.
Where?
And he said, it is a light thing that thou shouldest be my servant to raise up the tribes of Jacob and to restore the preserved of Israel.
Yes, yeah, so it says what? That God the Lord was talking here. So it's a light thing.
That thou shouldest be my servant.
Therefore, yeah, for us to be the Most High servant to go and raise up the tribes of Israel, which is from Judah, shaped up to Isaac, right? On the sign of the sign there. Right? Which are the 12 sons of Jacob. Right? We out here to give them warning of the destruction to come. Right? And to let them know of their transgressions at the Most High.
Exodus chapter 3 verse 13. And Moses said unto Pharaoh, behold, when I come unto the children of Israel, Exodus chapter 3 verse 13, it says, and Moses said unto God, behold, when I come unto the children of Israel, and shall say unto them, the God of your fathers hath sent me unto you.
Yes, so Moses was talking to the Most High, you understand, and Most High sent him to his children Israel, dwelling in the land of Egypt, into captivity. So basically, he had to know who sent him, because he didn't know the name.
The God of your father sent me unto you, and they shall say to me, what is his name? What shall I say unto them? Verse 40. And God said unto Moses, I am that I am. And he said, thus shalt thou say unto the children of Israel, I am and sent unto you.
Yes, so basically he is talking about himself, I am that I am. You understand, I am ascending, but...
And God said moreover...
Right, said moreover, meaning conclusion of... You understand, but...
Unto Moses, thus shalt thou say unto the children of Israel, the Lord God of your father, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac...
Right, he says what? The Lord God. Right, now if you go back into the Hebrew text, you'll see the same word in here. Because what they did, they took name, the actual name of when they're translating the book, right, and just put Lord, right? But the actual letters there was, the name there was Yahweh, right, which means he exists,
yeah,
right?
But that's what Moses said, but the Bible said that God said, I am.
Yes.
So, what in Hebrews, word, what I am?
Verse 14 says, and God said unto Moses, I am that I am.
In the Hebrew,
yeah.
No, in the Hebrew, I am that I am right there. You would have been saying, Ahaya, Asha, Ahaya. Ahaya, Asha, Ahaya. I am that I am. But he was talking to himself. Because Moses can't go and say, I am that I am.
No, so it's like, okay, if I tell you what to somebody, they ask me, say, I tell you my name. So obviously, his name is I am. And in Hebrew,
But you have to understand.
That's what you just said. So is that just the
Most High basically was exhorting himself. I will be that I will be. You understand?
No. Alright.
You have to understand.
No, I understand. But I am that I am have to be his name, right? Because
that is what he will call
himself. If I send you to him and he has to send you, call him, send you. You can't go and tell him I am that I am. No. Sorry. You can't go and tell him something else. You gotta go and tell me who sent you. Because you're getting whatever you went for. So if I tell you I am, if I say Paul, you're gonna tell me Paul. So since he said I am, so obviously never say Lord God, you never say Jesus, you never call
God. That is only your basic. Yeah, that point in time.
That has to be his name.
So as you're saying, Moses can't say, I am that I am a sending.
I am that I am sending.
Because he's just a messenger. Yeah, I will be your
guide.
Go ahead.
Verse 15 says, and God said, moreover, to Moses, thus shalt thou say unto the children of Israel, Lord God.
And God said, moreover, meaning conclusion of. You understand? Alright. Yeah, wait, when I'm related. Go ahead.
That's it. Thou shalt say unto the children of Israel, the Lord, God of your father, God of Abraham, God of Isaac, and God of Jacob.
Right? The Lord, God of your father. Meaning Yahweh. Right there, as I say in the Hebrew there, was Yahweh that the Most High said. Which means he exists. Go and tell the children of Israel that he exists as sending. Now think about it. If you're sick, you can translate Ahaya Asha Ahaya. In English, you could also translate it as I exist, have sent thee. Moses can come and say, I exist. You understand? Because it also goes back to I will be what I will be. But most I tell, which even though was an angel, you understand, was talking to Moses in bush because it was in Moses himself. You're saying, go and tell the children of Israel that he exists as sent thee.
Exodus chapter 3.
No, go back. You sent an angel, right?
Yeah.
And he asked exactly who sent him. I am which I am, the Lord God. So if the Lord sent him, how did the angel come?
Oh, the angel come in?
Yeah, where to find that?
Because you have to understand who was that angel there. But you bring it up on there.
Bring the scripture here, read.
Go ahead.
Go ahead.
So let's chapter 3, verse 2. It says, and the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a flame of fire out of the midst of a bush. And he looked, and behold, the bush burned with fire, and the bush was not consumed.
Yes, it says what? The angel of the Lord was speaking there. He burned the bush. You understand?
Yep, that's right.
Something
happened? Yeah. This is Acts chapter 7, verse 29. Then fled Moses at this saying, and was a stranger in the land of Midian, where he begat two sons. When 40 years were expired, there appeared unto him in the wilderness of Mount Sinai an angel of the Lord in the flame, in a flame of fire in a bush.
Yeah, and the sons of Israel back in the top was that they just fire a bush. But your question is now, who's been? No, she wanted to know why then the angel would say, I am that I am.
She killing the Most High said.
Yeah, but still, you're giving me a name.
Give me
Exodus 23, God.
What, 20?
What I mean to say is like,
20?
If somebody asks me, who am I? You understand? I really can't say who am I unless I know where I come from.
So,
who is God?
Most High name is Yahweh and His Son's name is Yahweh Shai.
Yeah, but who is He? Who is God?
Who is?
Yeah, who is
the Most High Power? Most High Power, the Creator of heaven and earth.
I understand what you're trying to say.
Who is? He's the Lord God of Israel. That you
know.
Okay,
all
they told me His name. I didn't want to know. Which that will come into that, obviously. Who he is, what's his name? It's like they probably want to know who is his father. Obviously, I have to tell him that who he is, and then tell him who is his name.
God is Jesus Christ. God is the Father, Son, the Holy Ghost.
Well, God.
Oh, baby, I'm hungry.
Anybody?
I would really love to pay
you. God must. God, God is anything. That's why I say. Excuse. That's why I say that God is. God could be anything. God could be. Anybody can make anything out of God. Just now. Ask a question. God could be this dustbin here. But that don't want to be the God of the Bible. Somebody could make that a God. Now, if you ask him about the God of the Bible, God of the Bible is not Jesus Christ. He's not Jehovah. He's not a higher. Yahweh, Hashem, Yahushai. That is God, the God of this book here. So I know that through the Spirit of God.
So he told you vision and those different things. Some people tend to just be followers.
Right?
Everybody have their own religion and just
Second Timothy chapter 3 verse 16. All scripture is given by inspiration of the Most High and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, and for instruction in righteousness.
Alright, that is good.
All scripture is given by inspiration of the Most High and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction.
Yes, it says all scriptures given by inspiration of the Most High. You understand the doctrine, which doctrine goes back here to teaching the all things, you understand? So that is how we know certain things by reading the book, because no other book out here could tell us the Most High, what is his name, or attributes or what's the next attribute is. You understand? So this is the only book, the scriptures put together. You understand?
All the books together is that's just a piece of the book.
No, that's the only book.
This is the only book that
we gave us.
We know that other books are what those people took them out. But as scriptures say, his mercies are, his grace is sufficient to the cross.
Yes.
You understand?
Yeah.
You know in part, you prophesy in part until that which is perfect God.
But, Mark, you believe in God?
Yes, of course.
You believe in God?
If I didn't, I would ask
you
a question.
Right, so you believe that God
if
will
I
let...
If I believe
in love,
yeah,
you believe God will let men destroy me, what? Or corrupt me, what?
Say in the last days, it will be revealed back unto faith and something.
But right, this is why you see...
This old men will have dreams.
If I can say this is why you're seeing we out here. We is babes and suckers. It's been revealed to us. So if you know, you're seeing it. Young men are seeing out here with Bible in the hands.
Romans 11, chapter 7.
All right, just now.
It says, what then? Israel had not obtained that which he seek.
No, so we out here preaching about the God of Israel. God, the power of Israel, not any other God, but the God of Israel.
That's right.
Which is Yahweh Yahushai. And the Israelites is the Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans today. So the scripture says, which you is an Israelite. The scripture says, what then Israel had not obtained that which you seek before, because all Israel looking for the truth. All Israel right now seeking for something, but not all Israel today.
It says, but the election had obtained it, and the rest were blinded.
The election obtained it, the rest were blinded. So that means that everybody can know this God, what we serving here right now, on this side. Because they were asking, who is God? We know who is God. We know who is the Most High through the Spirit. And not everybody will know the Most High through the Spirit. Is that good?
No, you just answered my question.
Oh.
Only time only given me scriptures, I have scriptures. You won't believe that is what I'm waiting for.
Oh, that way was through the Spirit. We know who is the Most High.
But the name that's all they give me there, the first time I'm here, but I've went to Jehovah's Witness, Full Gospel, Ethiopia, and nobody ever told me who was born. It's still unclear. And how they know that that's born? You understand? No pastor, no elder, nobody. First time I've ever heard somebody told me something that I actually wanted to hear. That I believe. The only way you can know who's God is. And that has to be a factor here. So, God can be anything, yes. But you gotta know it.
Yeah, who is the real God?
So nobody can tell you, no pastor can tell all you that this is God.
Yeah, you know who is God.
Tell me that, I don't want to hear that.
But not everybody will know who is God. I understand that too. Because why? Because why? Not Amos. Amos.
But you don't give him an answer. Tell him what I want.
But the book of Amos chapter 3 verse 7. Surely the Lord will do nothing but reveal the secrets of his servants, the prophets. We out here is the prophets. This is why I see we out here, we prophesy.
I can't ask right now, but I'm asking.
You know that, right?
If I hate, he hate, he make me. And whatever things up, I am
up to.
So, I don't have to ask that. Well, I don't feel like I need the Bible enough.
You need the Bible every day?
Every day we have devotion. Every day. My husband and my two kids.
So, I know the word.
But what I don't know, as they say, is me. All I'm knowing that I'm praying to the Almighty God. I'm praying and calling no name. I'm giving no name. Yes, you know who he is.
That's for
sure. I know the Bible.
Oh, Acts 20, Acts 17. But I Acts chapter 4 verse 20.
You are the Hebrew alphabet? On the tablet?
Yeah. Nah, on the tablet.
On the phone?
I'm gonna
pull it on my phone and I'm gonna
get this Muslim. David and all them with a set of wives, as far as I understand. Yes, they married all these women and still did wrong. So, is it right? Because women still come and make them do wrong things, but still blame women when they do good. They should blame themselves because they were tempted by the fools. Nobody can tell you to do that unless you want to. That's another story of itself. And I also wanted to know if man should have more than one wife.
David, because he was lustful after Bathsheba, right? So Abraham, when not the wife couldn't make babies, he still got the first corruption. So is it right to have all these women? But believe me, I'm married, yes. If I find my man with the next woman, yes, I'll forgive him. But I feel forgiveness to one man. You don't forgive him once. After that, there's no more forgiveness. So,
I've given that scripture. We could have more than one wife. You could have more than one wife.
You could have. That many scriptures are proven.
Me